the reason I came to San Francisco was to assist Reverend Tobase in June 1952. And I began assisting Sokoji activities. I think a year or two, Reverend Tobase left, and Shunryu Suzuki came afterwards. So as I did to Tobase, I assisted him while he was in San Francisco. The project I was working is I was intermingled with young people, you know, like Sunday schools and Buddhist schools. Generally, I was assisting Reverend Suzuki for ceremonies, cleaning the area. Around the early 50s, 53, 55 or so, Alan Watts came from New York to San Francisco, and on Broadway Street, nice old mansion, he used that as his headquarters, from where he broadcasted Zen Buddhism, Taoism, etc. And I think 1955, Zen boom became a sort of a common terms among the people. And actually, I was associated with Alan Watts around 1955 for his Zen boom activities. He couldn't read Japanese, so I translated Chinese and Japanese Zen text for Alan Watts, so that lots of Alan Watts talks I prepared for him. I was teaching Zen Buddhism at American Academy of Asian Studies, where Alan Watts was headed. Usually about 8 to 10 or 12 students were there, and I was talking about Zen Buddhism, but since Zen Buddhism is not actually verbal level, you know, it is action. You have to sit and experience Zazen. So we started to sit and do the Zazen, yeah. And interestingly, I was paid for lecture, but I didn't speak, you know, we just sat together. Nonetheless, you know, those members were not only satisfied there. So those people began moving away from American Academy of Asian Studies and started Zen Buddhism at Sokoji Temple. Sokoji Temple was built by Japanese community. There was some minor frictions between Japanese people and American people, because the Japanese people spent so much money to build a temple, and then Americans come and they started to use it without contributing much money. So actually, that was a sort of a slight dispute, not serious ones. But Americans sensed, and they moved to Page Street in San Francisco. San Francisco Zen Center began after I came to Los Angeles. So the originally American Academy students, they were the founding members of the Zen Center. Originally, Reverend Suzuki resigned San Francisco, and he headed there. But shortly after he died, and Richard Baker took over. In 1963, Bishop Yamada Reirin, who became Zenji, top of the Soto Zen later, came to my house and asked me to come to Los Angeles to help him. And Then he immediately established an institute. It's called Zen Koryo Kenkyujo. It means Zen Study Center. And he needed a lecturer there. And Katagiri was one of two students. I happened to be a lecturer because of Yamada Reirin's request. So that was the initial relationship with Katagiri. And Katagiri later went to San Francisco and helped for a short period of time at Sokoji for Suzuki Shunryu. Then he moved to Minnesota and he established his own Zen Center. Maizumi Roshi came about the same time as I was, 1950s, and his age was about my age. Actually, he is a year younger than me. I came to San Francisco and Maizumi came to Los Angeles, Zenshuji here. He began separating from here and started to Zen Center.